Hi, my name's Aaron Tweedy, and I'm from Front Royal, Virginia. I'm here today seeking $200,000 for a 29% stake in my company, Manpack. The Manpack is a sling-styled vertical messenger bag designed by guys for guys. You know, 40 years ago, men carried nothing more than a money clip. But times have changed. On average, guys now carry 4.5 pounds of stuff. Things like keys, cell phones, tablets, energy drinks. Point is, guys need to carry stuff, and we have very few options. We have the backpack, the briefcase, the traditional messenger bag, and I'm sure all of you remember the fanny pack. I have designed a superior product that I call Urban Tactical. You can wear this thing three different ways. First way is bandolier style. If you need to take it off quickly, it has a quick release clasp. A chest-mounted utility pocket for your cell phone with a magnetic button closure. Line it up, locks itself shut. Three rows of Molly for tactical gear, and a collapsible beverage holder. When you need it, it's there. When you don't,
it
falls
up. Not the collapsible beverage holder!
It folds up and out of the way. To get into it, you don't need to take it off. Just spin it around and open it up. Plus, you have auxiliary pockets for things like your wallet, loose pocket change, keys. Now, if you're someplace where you're gonna take it on and off frequently, you can throw it over one shoulder. Notice how the weight still hangs over your lower back due to the ergonomic design of the strap. And if you're in the city, on the metro, you can wear it in reverse, keep your possessions in front of you, and safe from pickpockets. The mission statement of Manpack is to make men more prepared, because a prepared man is a better man. With your support, we can turn the man bag market into the man pack market. Thank you for the opportunity to present, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Aaron, what's your background?
Are you kidding, baby?
That was really good. What's your background? Are you a designer?
No. I built my first house when I was 19, and I was in Fort Benning, Georgia when I was 17.
Were you in the Army?
I was.
You know, when you first walked in, I looked at it and I thought, oh, another knapsack for guys, whatever. But you definitely wowed me with the utility of it.
Can we see them? Can we take a look at one?
Sure, yes.
For you.
Thank you.
Here you go.
Give me the black one. Thanks.
You get the XL.
Yeah.
Yeah, he needs the XL. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Have you sold any of these?
I have.
What are your sales?
Okay, so last year, 76,000. This year, we're at 65,000 year to date.
Is that online?
What do you think you're gonna do this year?
145.
What do you sell them for?
$59.95.
And what do you make them for?
They cost, right now, $22.05 a piece.
So this product requires an explanation, because it's hard to differentiate it against anything else.
That's true. You have to educate the consumer, because this is an emerging market.
Bags are emerging market?
This is the millennial version of the MRS.
But it's not, right, it's not a purse, it's not a backpack.
Aaron, here,
it's a man,
you know,
it's a man purse.
But Aaron, here's the concern. When I was in Europe last summer with my family,
right,
I had a similar bag, and I wasn't ashamed to wear it in public because every other guy in Europe had one.
Exactly.
When I came back here, I put the same thing on. I didn't make it one block down the street. Everybody was laughing at me.
You know,
but that's not MRS.
Robert, I don't think they were laughing at you for that.
You know, a couple of things. One, it's not MRS. When you see the guys that I sell to, the Secret Service agents and military personnel and law enforcement personnel.
I never laugh at somebody with a gun.
Right, exactly.
Well, let's go to the real numbers. How many did you sell last month, online only?
Probably like 40. You know, I mean, it's not good, but I started this with $5,000. I've been doing a lot with next to nothing.
Why do you think the company's worth $700,000?
Okay, $50,000 for the design patent, which we...
But what did you get the design patent for?
For this model.
Like what, a bag with a strap that has so many pockets?
It's just the look of it.
What else are you adding to the value?
A multiple of sales for 2 years, being the $145,000 projection, $18,000 intellectual property, that being the bank of YouTube commercials that I've created. They're really funny, you should check them out.
You're putting a hard value on those.
Value is a matter of perception. And if we're on,
yes, it
if
is.
We're on an island and you have a bar of gold and I have a cheeseburger, who's rich?
I'll take the gold.
Okay.
Then get in the plane and leave the island.
Let's go. Robert, hold on. Are we done? Are we done with all the numbers? I'll just...
No, okay. Well. And $200,000 in goodwill.
And $200,000 in goodwill.
If I gave you $200,000, I'd have to own about 260% of the company. About that. Because you have very small sales. That's the reason I'm out. I'm just a disciplined financial investor.
I understand.
Yeah, I kind of agree with Kevin. I think this is a hard business to invest in. I think you're a hustler and you're a great salesperson. I just think it's hard for you to scale, which makes it hard to invest in. And so for those reasons, I'm out.
We've seen many people with
good sales, bad sales, and then we normally bet on the person. And thank you for serving our country.
Thank you.
We also look for small indications on how good this partner would be. I'm gonna charge $20,000 for your videos that you may have made at home. It indicated that you don't have a sense of financial intelligence when it comes to what partners need and operating this business. And for that reason, I'm out.
I have to tell you, as impressed as I am with you, to me, it looks like a messenger bag. So you've got to go and you got to run real fast, baby. You got to get out there, but that's a journey for you. And you're a tough guy. Ex-military, I think you're going to do it. You're not going to do it in the time frame that I want to do it in. For that reason, I'm out.
I don't know that much about what men carry around, but I do know that in all my years in retail and on QVC and creating products, the hardest thing is when there's just a ton of competition and you're not even sure how popular the market is for it. And we're not sure how many people are going to be buying the product. And for that reason, I'm out.
Very well.
I wish you all the best, though.
All right. Well, thank you guys very
much. Good luck,
Aaron. Good luck.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Good luck.
What it comes down to is that they didn't like my valuation. I'm sure they would have liked to have 70% of the business for 20 grand. And, you know, I look forward into the future, and I know that it's going to be worth a lot more because I'm going to make it worth a lot more.